Before I go any further, I just kind of wanted to talk to you guys about the contest. You're probably going to start asking, and I just need, it's a matter of me getting together with my sister and reviewing everything. I want to thank everybody who participated in the contest, and hopefully we'll be able to come up with a decision ASAP for you guys. But yeah, so that's where we're at. It's just a matter of me and my sister getting together. What's cooking, good looking? It's me. A lot of you probably know that I have been away for the past couple of weeks. I went on vacation. I went to Japan for 1 week, and then I went to China for the next week. And I had a lot of fun. Thanks for everybody who's asked how my trip was. It was a lot of fun. I'll probably talk about it a little bit more in another video. But for right now, what I want to talk about is the makeup that I brought with me when I was on my trip. NalaNani2121, I hope I said the name right, requested that I do a quick little video about the makeup that I brought with me on my trip. The first thing that I think you would probably find interesting is the color of eyeshadows that I decided to bring with me. Now, I didn't have any specific thought, you know, process when I picked my colors. All I knew is that I wanted to bring something as easy as possible, so something small and manageable. So what I decided to bring was my MAC, obviously, but the first and foremost thing that I needed to bring was my quad. This is my quad. It's a little dirty, but this is the only quad that I have right now, and this is my go-to quad. If I'm running late in the morning, I just go to my quad, and this is what I use. I have Brune. Brune is what I use for my eyebrows, and when I want to deepen the crease. This right here is Woodwinked, and when I got Woodwinked, actually, my sister was trying to talk me out of it because she said it's just like any other gold color. But, hello, gold is like my favorite color. I love wearing gold, you know. I'm wearing gold right now. I mean, it's not just any color. It's Woodwinked. And it actually made it to my quad. So, yeah. So that's what I usually, like right now, I have it on my eyelid. And then I have two highlights. You're probably going to ask me why I have two highlights, but I'll explain in a second. So the first one is rice paper. And rice paper is my favorite highlight to put here up at the top. And the second one is shroom. And shroom used to be my favorite highlight to put here, but now it has changed. I still love it. I just use it more for regular highlighting. So I put it on my nose, I put it here, a little bit on my Cupid's bow, and I'm good to go. So that's why, without a doubt, I had to bring this quad. Now, of course, I live in a colorful world too, so I needed to bring color with me. I have two MAC palettes right now, and a lot of people organize their MAC palettes between neutrals and then like crazy colors, but I don't do that. One, because I don't really have enough MAC colors just yet. Well, I have a lot, but I don't feel like I have a lot, if that makes any sense. And two, because I feel like it will stifle my creativity if I have, you know, everything organized nicely. So I keep everything a jumbled mess. So this is the palette that I decided to take, and I moved some stuff around and took some stuff out of my other palette, but this is basically it. I don't know what this stuff is right now. I think it's from my hair product. Let's ignore it. So these are the colors that I ended up taking with me. Vanilla, Silver Ring, Amber Lights, Sumptuous Olive, Flourishing, Humid. Dang, this is like a quiz. Coppering, Gold Mine, Satellite Dreams, I believe, Satin Taupe, Blackberry, this is Shadowy Lady, Carbon, Plumage, and Contrast. Okay, so that's all the colors that I got. And I just really brought them because they're the ones that caught my eye at the moment that I was packing. That's really the only excuse I have. One thing that I want to talk about is Golden Olive, paired with plumage was a really nice look that I put together because it went with a dress that I wore when we went to the Great Wall of China. So I really liked that look. Another dress that I wore was kind of like a burnt orange color. And so what I ended up doing was wearing copper ring with gold mine. And I actually put gold mine right here at the lower lash line. And I don't know, something about when I did that and then I put my eyeliner on, it made me look more Asian. So I kind of liked that look. It was fitting. Okay, so on top of that, I also brought my wonderful blush with me. This is my blush. It's broken now, though. It fell and all the little pieces. Oops, I just got that on my laptop. The little pieces fell apart. But this is a cheap blush. Milani, and the number is number 5, and it's called Copper Sunshine, and I like it because it's like an orangey color, and I love orange as a blush. Let me clean my laptop for a second. So I was using that blush, and I brought all of my brushes, well, the ones that I thought were important, and I brought them in this little bag here, but as you can see, it's all dirty now. But it's you're supposed to hold all your brushes. Look at how dirty it is. That's because my blush broke. Anyway, so you put all your brushes in here, and then you fold it up, and then you tie it closed. So this is really good for traveling. And the brushes that I brought were basically these. This was my 187, and sorry, but it's really dirty right now. This is a 129, but this is the special edition for my blush. This is the Smashbox brow brush that I got from Love for All Things, which I love, and I use it every day for my brows now. And then this is just a cheapy brush. I don't even remember what the brand was, but I use this to put my face powder on. And then these two brushes for eyeshadow. So, yeah, these two. Basically, this is a... Oh, darn. I don't know the number of this one. I think this is a 222, and this one is a 224. And that was it when it came to brushes. My mascara was my wonderful Lash Blast. For my hair. Oh, no, let's go with my face. So for my face, okay, this is why I'm so excited. So I've been really, really trying to take care of my skin for the past 6 months. I used to be kind of bad at washing my face every day, and I didn't really moisturize, and I didn't really tone. So I had kind of really bad skin, and I hid it a lot by using a lot of foundation. And I grew very dependent on foundation, and I felt like I couldn't leave the house without foundation. So I have been taking my skin routine very seriously, to the point where beginning on this trip, I went off of my foundation. It's like I went off of life support. And I picked up this Aveeno Tinted Moisturizer. And this is all I wore. Basically, no foundation, just tinted moisturizer. And I'm super duper excited and happy that I can walk around and feel comfortable just wearing this tinted moisturizer. So I think that's awesome. I'm so happy and proud of myself. Somebody left me a message in one of my videos when I was talking about my wonderful Redken shampoo and how I was having problems with frizz. I still have a little frizz right now, but whatever. It's not as bad as it usually is. And this person suggested to me that I try the Matrix Sleek in the orange bottle. So I bought it, and I love it. It's really great. So I think the screen name was Carol Garza. Thank you very much for suggesting the Matrix in the orange bottle. When I actually went to the store to buy this, I realized that I had tried Matrix before, but I always called it Biolage. And this is my favorite thing. It's a leave-in cream, and I put it on every single day. Last but not least, one of the most important things, I brought my spoon, because you all know that I curl my eyelashes with a spoon. I brought my spoon, and then I brought my eyeliner. This is 24/7 in 0, And then this is just, I think, a L'Oreal liquid liner. That's everything, and I hope that you found this interesting. And hopefully you guys will all get to go on vacation soon and get to pack all your makeup. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.